Fit for the race. When we say fit, it means what are the qualities
that we have.
What does it mean? What is that
race
that God has given us? As a parent, as a leader, as a mother, as a father. So please, open the Bible with me. And I'm going to run faster because I have less than
29
minutes. Hebrews chapter 12, the Bible says, wherefore sin also encompassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses. Somebody say cloud of witnesses. Sorry, sir. Cloud of witnesses. Cloud of witnesses. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1.
Because now, we have been here with someone. You will provide you and with them.
Okay, then looking unto Jesus. Okay, then let you get the paper say, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which does so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. Okay, so when we talk about this race, we mean about the, you know what's that? So when we talk about the race, we mean the assignment that is set before us. Jesus ran a race.
Yes, what's that?
The Bible says that he endured.
He was a very father.
All the insults.
He
endured everything. Just because of the grace, of the crown that was set before him. Just because of you and I. Jesus endured the race.
Yes, what's that?
The Bible says we have the cloud of witnesses. When we look at it, the book of Hebrews chapter 11, which in theology we categorize it to mean the hall of faith. So when we're talking about that, we're talking about Joseph, we're talking about Abraham, we're talking about Moses, we're talking about David, we're talking about Solomon, we're talking about Elijah, we're talking about Ruth, we're talking about Deborah, we're talking about everybody, and at the same time, the Bible was referring to my mother. The same way the Bible is referring to every mother here present. We have the cloud of witnesses around us. We have no excuses. Meaning that let us lay aside. So meaning that all these people that we're talking about, they ran the race, they had their challenges. Moses had challenges. David had plenty. Our Lord Jesus Christ had. Did they give any excuse? No. What did they do? They laid aside every weight, everything that will not allow them to remain focused. The Bible says, lay them aside. So as mothers, in the vineyard of God, as mothers, being parents to their children, when you lay aside every weight, when you lay aside every sin, when you lay aside irrelevant associations, when you lay aside that will not allow you to remain focused. Those things that will not allow you to focus on the way you raise your children, it will deliver unto you 5 or 6 things.
The first thing
that will deliver unto you is the knowing. The second one is understanding. The third one is comprehending. The fourth one is mastering. The fifth one is managing. Then the sixth one is called what we call maximizing. Meaning that, you know, as a mother, you are to manage, you are to deal with your brain, to deal with your children, and to deal with who? To deal with your husband. The husband and the children you don't know, which is the knowing, you will not be able to understand. The husband and the child or the children you did not understand, it will be pretty difficult for you to comprehend that children or the husband. And the children and the husband you fail to comprehend what will happen, it will be difficult for you to gain mastery over there. And when you fail to gain mastery over your children, you gain mastery over the way you relate with your husband, it will be difficult for you to manage. And somebody, especially our children, we can't manage. It will be difficult for us to be able to maximize their potential.